What's up, everybody? It is Luke Beller. So the Packers have apparently met with another player, Notre Dame edge Dalen Hayes. And this makes sense just because with the draft coming up, they have to meet with some of these college players to see if they could potentially be a good fit. So I'll break that down. If you guys are new to the channel, I put up Packers news, breakdowns, all that kind of stuff 6 times a week. So if you want to see that, feel free to subscribe to the channel down below. So taking a look at Mr. Dalen Hayes, he was a 4-star recruit coming out of Michigan. Like this was when he was in high school. He was ranked as the 133rd recruit in the nation back in whatever year that was, a long time ago, when he was in high school. He then goes on where he spent 5 seasons with Notre Dame. That partly had to do with the fact that he did deal with a 2019 injury. He played in the first few games of that season, but then went down and missed the rest of the year. So he comes back in 2020, and he definitely had a great comeback year in 2020. He finished with 17 tackles, 6 tackles for loss, 3 sacks, 1 interception, and 2 forced fumbles. So a pretty good finish from him coming back in the 2020 season. So I went and did some research sort of on what people think of this guy, the kind of player that they see him being in the NFL. I found all this information from Pro Football Network. They have an entire like draft profile on this guy. So I found some good parts that I thought I should share with you guys. So first off, they say Dalen Hayes certainly looks the part as an edge rusher. He stands around 6'3" or 6'4" and has an extremely dense, thick frame at 270 pounds. Hayes isn't thrown around easily and he has fairly good play strength. So he seems to be a pretty strong guy at 270 pounds. Definitely would be tough for me to block him. Then they go on to say, Hayes is more effective as a run defender, so he's better in the run. Here, his serviceable length allows him to establish an anchor against offensive linemen, and he has the strength to break free and make plays when necessary. When Hayes is unblocked, he knows how to cover ground efficiently in pursuit, and the Notre Dame edge also has a lateral quickness to evade lone blockers. So it seems that even though he does play in the edge, which you would think maybe he's great at, you know, stopping the passer. Golly, bro. Okay. So even though he is on the edge, you would assume, you know, he's probably good at rushing the passer. It seems that he's more efficient when it comes to being a run defender. So maybe if he were to be drafted by the Packers, that would be something he could potentially develop because you don't want to have an edge guy out there who, you know, can't bring pressure to the quarterback. You would like them to be able to do that too. So hopefully that's something that he could develop if he were, you know, to come to the Green Bay Packers. And then here's some negative things they said about his game that they think he needs to work on. So it says one negative that is fairly conclusive, however, pertains to Hayes' speed. He's not much of a speed threat. Even on his more explosive reps, he often wins with tenacious hand technique and not with consistent speed around the edge. Without overwhelming length, bend, or explosiveness, this puts a relatively low cap on Hayes' pass rushing upside. Unless he can glean more explosiveness with an NFL workout regimen, he may be limited at the next level. So it seems that because he is lacking some speed, he may not be, you know, one of the best players at the next level. He may be limited in that area and may be something that teams need to look out for, you know, when they want to draft him. So now they finish off saying, for now, Hayes is a late day 3 prospect. He doesn't have the ideal explosiveness or bend for a 3-4 outside linebacker role. And while his size better meshes in a 4-3, he's not a menace as a pass rusher. He also appears too lean to add weight and transition to a 3-4 defensive end role. So he seems to be more of a player that maybe would be drafted like, I don't know, 5th through the 7th round, a guy who would come in, maybe you don't expect too much from, maybe add some depth, maybe develop alongside some of these other players like Za'Darius Smith, like Rashawn Gary. Hopefully he can pick up some things at the NFL level, but he doesn't seem to be, you know, a guy that's going to go in the early rounds. So the Packers do want to bring him in. He's likely a guy that will take time to develop, and hopefully, you know, he can maybe reach that next level. But that is all I wanted to break down in today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you guys on the next video. Peace out.